Dear brothers and sisters, many times in life we wonder if we are living in a manner in which we should be living. We pass through the ups and downs of life and then we feel, are we leading a life which will give us total satisfaction? And when we start to ponder on that question, then we start to look at what this life is all about and how to make this life better for us. Everyone wants to be happy. Everyone wants to be joyous. Everyone wants to be fulfilled. We all want to make sure that all our needs are met. And so as we start to ponder on the question as to which way we should be leading our life, we then start to look at the depths of what this life is all about. There's a very interesting story about a poor man. This man used to work hard, but he could hardly make a living for him and his family. And one day, as he was working, it so happened that a rich person was passing through that area and ran into some difficulty. So this poor person, who was a very helping person, was a very simple person. He helped the rich person, and the rich person, after his difficulty had been relieved, was very happy with this poor person. So the rich person, who owned lots and lots and lots of land, he gave a tract of his land on which there was sandalwood which was growing, because he felt that this poor person would then be able to lead a life in which all his responsibilities would be easily fulfilled. The poor person thanked him, the rich person went on his way, and many years passed by. The poor person would take some wood from the forest and would sell it as regular wood to build houses and to have people put wood into the fireplaces. And with the money that he got, his life was just going on a little better than before. Many years passed by, and one day the rich person happened to be passing by the same area. So he remembered that he'd helped a poor person there, and so he searched for him to see how well the person was living. But when he found the person, he still was living in the same old hut. His clothes were not that much better than what he'd seen before. So the rich person asked this poor man as to what had he done with the forest, because the forest had been cut down. And how come he wasn't living better than what it was? So the poor man said, oh, I was using the forest. Every few months I would cut some of the trees down and give it to the builders to build houses and to other people to use it firewood. It was then that the rich person told this poor man that that forest has sandalwood on it, which is very, very expensive. And you just squandered away this great opportunity that I gave you to be wealthy. And so when we look at our lives and we start to look at what is it that we've received here, we find that God has given us this opportunity of being able to be in this physical body. We find in this world, there are many kinds of species of living here. Animals, birds, fish, mammals, insects, When we look at their lives, they are just leading their lives for survival. When they get hungry, they try to find food to eat. If a bigger animal than them comes around to hunt for them, then they're running for their survival. And when they have the instinct, then they go and raise a family. And so the animals are living in a manner in which they are just surviving. And when we start to look at our lives as human beings, we realize that along with what the animals are doing, we've also been given a higher angle of vision. We've been given means by which we can understand what is happening with us. We've been given the intelligence by which we can explore not only about the body, but also our mental capabilities, our intellectual capabilities, and then finally, the very reason for which we have this physical body is to explore our spiritual capabilities. And so then the question comes in, are we using this opportunity that God has given us to be able to reach the heights for which we all have received this human body? Human beings have been given compassion. Human beings have been given the traits of being able to differentiate between right and wrong. Human beings have been given a heart to love, to care, to share. And these are the high nobles of life that we all have received as we come into this human frame. It is for us to make use of these capabilities. And if we don't, then our life would be like that of that poor man. Having received all the wealth that is there for us to lead satisfying lives, we need to make use of what we have been provided with. If we have the resources, but we don't use them, then we are the ones who don't benefit from the resources that we have. And so God the Creator has given us an opportunity to truly, truly find out about life itself. God has given us this opportunity to live in this physical world and be able to explore what this life is all about. God has given us this opportunity in which not only do we live at the physical level on a day-to-day basis, but we have the faculties by which we can rise above physical body consciousness. When we can explore the realms beyond the physical, when we can go on a spiritual journey, when we can experience ourselves as we truly are, and it's only in the human body that all the faculties that are required by us to know ourselves truly have been provided. So once we have those faculties, we need to make use of them. Then only will this life be fulfilled. Then only are we going to take steps towards our goal. It's only then that the very purpose for which we've come into this world will get to be fulfilled. God has been very gracious on each and every one of us. If you look at creation, and if you look at all the species that are there, there are millions of these pieces. If you look at the animals and the birds and the fish and the insects, there are so many of them. And once we start to think about the human being as just one out of many millions of species that there are, look at the chances of being able to get this human body. You know, many people buy lottery tickets in the hope of winning that lottery. But very, very few people are able to win. And so our chances of getting the human body are much less than the chances of someone winning a lottery. And so when we have this opportunity in which God has provided all the means that are needed for us to lead a fulfilling life, then we need to make use of this opportunity. So how do we make use of the opportunity of being in this physical body? First, we need to recognize who we truly are. We need to truly dig in and experience who we are. If we only live at the level of our physical senses, then we'll just think of ourselves as being the human body. We might go a little beyond that and think of ourselves as being an emotional being. We would go beyond that and think of ourselves as an intellectual being. We'll just remain at that level. Each and every one of us has been given what is called the single eye, the third eye, the spiritual eye, which is here between and behind the two eyebrows. So each human being has that. That's a gateway that leads us into the spiritual regions. So we need to learn the techniques of being able to focus our attention there so that we are uplifted into the regions beyond, and with help and guidance, we can go on the spiritual journey. Saints and mystics have talked about the spiritual journey. Saints and mystics have talked about our real self as being our soul. Our soul, which is a part of God, our soul, which is conscious, our soul, which is full of the love and light of God. And that soul can be recognized by us, that can be experienced by us. Just like we have experiences in the physical world outside, we can have experiences of a soul, which is conscious, which can soar into the spiritual regions, and which can, with help and guidance, merge with the Creator and be all-knowing. So we have those capabilities to get to that state. The key is to take our attention away from the world outside, because wherever we focus our attention, that's what we'll become. And so take it away from the world outside, focus it within ourselves. And as we focus our attention within, then only are we going to go on the spiritual journey. Sant Rajinder Singh Ji Maharaj very beautifully talked about the spiritual journey. He says, Khaak se taaba kya kasha, humne to jab kiya safar, ish mila kadam kadam, hus mila nazar nazar. So when we translate this into English, it would be, when I traveled from the earth, earthy to the heaven, heavenlies, I found love at every step and beauty in every glance. So Sant Rajinder Singh Ji Maharaj is telling us about the inner journey. So he's saying, when I rose above physical body consciousness and I went into the spiritual regions within, so when I traveled from the earth, earthy to the heaven, heavenly, he says, I found love at every step and beauty in every glance. So the journey was a journey of love. I experienced more love and more love and more love as I went on this journey, because I was experiencing the love of God. And I saw more beauty and more beauty and more beauty than anything that I had experienced before, because it was getting more ethereal, I was getting more conscious of myself and the environment in which I'm living. You know, when we think about creation, when we think about the Creator, and we think about ourselves, as we go on the spiritual journey, we start to realize, hey, we're a part of the Creator. You know, in this life, it's the parents who are responsible to create children. But what is very interesting is, as soon as the parent has a child, the love that the parent feels for the child cannot be put into words. The parent would sacrifice anything for the child. The parent would do anything so the life of the child would get better. The parent shows so much love to the child that the child doesn't recognize that love till the child becomes a parent themselves. How many times have we heard people talk about how they realize how much their parents love them when they had their own children? God loves us tremendously. We only experience God's love as we go on the spiritual journey. As long as we are focused on the world outside, all we experience is interactions with others. But once we go on the inner journey and we experience God's love and we experience the divine light and sound of God, there's clarity in our vision. There's this realization that we are connected with the Creator. And when we are connected with the Creator, then we realize that just like we are connected with the Creator, so is everyone else. And the realization that we're all a part of one family, we're all part of the great family of the Creator, sets in. And then, whosoever we meet doesn't seem to be different from us, they all seem to be our very own. Because we then are seeing an extension of God in every other living form. There's a very interesting example out of the life of one person who'd come from overseas to India in the times of Sant Rajinder Singh. This person had come to attend one of the spiritual conferences which was organized by Sant Rajinder Singh. So when he came there and he experienced the love of God through the grace of Sant Rajinder Singh, he found so much love in his being that in the Savan Ashram, the place where Sant Rajinder Singh would reside, and many, many people would come to listen to his discourses and to be with him, this person who'd come from another country was saying, hugging trees. And so someone asked him, what are you doing? Why are you hugging trees? And he, who had understood what life was all about, told them that they are my own. They're also my brothers and sisters. When we look at the life of Sant Rajinder Singh, it's very interesting that in the house that he built in Savan Ashram and the house that he built in Manav Kendra, the house was built around a tree so that the tree would not be cut. He had so much love and regard for all living forms, whether they be animals or birds or fish or trees, because he realized that there was life in each and every one of them. And as we go on the spiritual journey, that's the realization that we have. And this is why when we go on the spiritual path, so much emphasis is placed on being a vegetarian. To lead a life in which you don't have to kill anyone else. To lead a life in which we bring love and joy into our environment and not destruction. To lead a life in which help would come from us to everyone else. And when we start to lead that kind of life, then life gets to be fulfilled. It's in giving that we receive, it's in helping someone else that we get the gains. It's being able to see God in each and every one, that we are totally fulfilled. And that all starts as we rise above physical body consciousness. And rising above physical body consciousness is called meditation. So let us meditate for a few minutes. Please sit as comfortably as you can. Close your eyes very gently, just like you close them when you go to sleep. Your eyeball should be straight, focus 8 or 10 inches in front of you. And as you close your eyes, those of you who have been initiated in the mysteries of the beyond, please do your simran. And those of you who are new here, please repeat any name of God that you feel comfortable with. This repetition of God's name should be done mentally and not out loud. I pray to God Almighty and to the three great spiritual masters of the past century, Hazur Baba Savan Singh Ji Maharaj, Param Sant Kripal Singh Ji Maharaj, and Dayal Purush Sant Darshan Singh Ji Maharaj, to help each and every one of us connect with the divine power within and to experience the divine light in its effulgence. We'll be sitting for a few minutes. I'll be getting you out of this meditative state at that time. And my best wishes are with each and every one of you. please leave off, Chordi Deji.